Hey guys, Jay Seeney here, and welcome to the Australian Wealth Channel, where we talk about everything from investing, finance, the stock market, real estate, everything to do with getting financially free. And today is a really important topic about how to invest if you have no idea. Okay, so I know that there's a lot of folks out there that have a few hundred dollars or a few thousand dollars that they want to invest. They're not really sure of what to do with their money, but they know that investing is a thing and is something that you can do. I was once in that position, and then after years and years of research and learning, I've learned a lot about the stock market and real estate investing and such. Now, this advice is not specific advice for you. Your circumstances are different to mine. This is only my experience. I'm one guy on the internet. So anything that you want to do with your money, you need to do your own research and look into it yourself. So if you have no idea about investing, the first thing is that there's a lot of different asset classes. So you could be looking to invest in real estate. You could be looking to invest in the stock market. You could be looking to invest in bonds, other types of fixed income. There's so many different types. So when you're investing, it's really important to smash the like button and subscribe to this channel so you can keep updated with all the latest videos. It really helps the channel and helps push these videos out to more people so that they can get this information too. So if you wouldn't mind hitting the like button and subscribing, that would be fantastic. What I would suggest for those that are starting out completely in the beginning is that real estate is going to be too expensive. So the best thing you can do with a small amount of money is start to invest in the stock market. When I first started, that's exactly what I did. So first of all, what is the stock market? So the stock market is basically a collection of publicly traded companies where any person can buy and sell shares on the open market. So a share is an ownership percentage of that company. So if you buy one share of Apple, technically you own a piece of the Apple Corporation. And same thing for any company that you can buy shares in publicly. You own a piece of that company. And as a result, if that company does really well, and grows much bigger, gets more profitable, that company is going to get valued more. And your shares in that company are going to become worth more money. Companies list on the public exchange so that they can get more access to capital to continue to grow their business. So by you buying a share, you're helping to prop up the stock price for them so it's easier for them to raise money at a higher value. So there's many stock markets all around the world. In Australia, there's the ASX. Over in America, you have the NYSE, and you also have the NASDAQ exchange. And there's stock markets all around the globe, England, Germany, etc., that list different companies. So the thing with the stock market is the value of your shares can go up and they can also go down. So that's something really important to remember. So buying just one company can be quite a risky endeavor, because if you're quite new and you're not sure what you're doing, you might actually choose a company that ends up going bankrupt and the value of your shares will go to zero. So the best thing that you can do when you're first starting is to invest in what they call an index fund. Now, what is an index fund? So an index fund tracks the performance of hundreds of companies all at once in the one share price. So when you buy into an ETF, an exchange traded fund, these funds will track at 100 companies, sometimes more, 500, 1,000 companies. So what that means is that your risk is completely diversified. You're not just investing in one company, you're investing in the top 200, top 500 biggest companies in Australia, in America, in the UK, wherever you choose to invest. This is a much safer way to play it, especially when you're starting out. If you invest in one company and it goes bankrupt, that's not so great. But if the top 500 companies in all of the world go bankrupt, which is highly unlikely, then there's much bigger problems in the world. So the name of that game is diversifying your wealth. So that way you're not tied to one company and it's much, much safer for you. So there's many different index funds that you can buy into. So as I said, there's some that are in Australia. The ASX 200, which will track the top 200 biggest companies in Australia. So for example, Qantas, the Commonwealth Bank, Wesfarmers, Coles, Rio Tinto, they are all within the ASX 200. Or you might decide that America has much better opportunities for innovation and growth. So you could look at investing in the S&P 500, which tracks the top 500 companies in the US. So that gives you access and exposure to names such as Alphabet, which is Google, Amazon, FedEx, Microsoft, Apple, Visa, Intel, Netflix, and hundreds more of those names of these large companies that are doing great numbers and making great profits every single year. So as these companies become more profitable over time, the value of your investment goes up. So with an index fund, you're basically banking on the future prosperity of that country, whether it be Australia or America, or it might be the top 500 global companies. There's many different types of index funds, so you can diversify even further again. So how do you buy these index funds? The easiest way to buy index funds is to open a brokerage account. So here in Australia, I personally use CMC Markets, which I find has worked really well for many years now, but there's a lot of different options. CMC Markets, there's also Self Wealth and many others. So it's just a quick look around. I personally use CMC and they've been fantastic. I've never had any dramas with them. For US shares, I use Stake, and that gives me access to a ton of American shares, individual companies, and also index funds, which allows me to track the top 500 companies in the US, the NASDAQ, which includes companies like Apple and Google and many others. So the first thing you need to do is get the brokerage, and then you start to put money into your brokerage account. And then from there, you can begin to buy shares. So with index funds, I find it's best not to just dump all of your money in straight away, because you could dump everything in and next minute the stock market goes down 5% the next day and you'll freak out and you'll be like, okay, well, I can't buy anymore. So the best thing that you can do is put away small amounts every single week. Some days the stock market will go up, some days the stock market will go down. That is just the nature of the game. Over time, however, you'll find that on average, the S&P 500 in the US has returned at least 7% every year on average. Some years it's way more, like last year it was 28%. At the moment this year, the S&P has returned -3%. So some years your investment will go up in value and some years it will go down. But the important thing is to consistently invest over time. So it's very much a long-term game. Investing is very different to trading. With investing, you need to have a time frame of 10, 20, 30 years. And the reason for this is that the power of compound interest is so powerful. So I just want to run you through an example quickly of where you can actually go when you invest in index funds. So it's all about those small amounts every single week, every single month that lead to massive returns in the long run. So if you invest $1,000 a month, which isn't a crazy amount of money, in 30 years, you've invested $360,000, which sounds like quite a lot of money, but the incredible part of this is that your portfolio would likely be worth upwards of $1.2 million. Because what's happened is over those 30 years, the assets that you've been holding have appreciated in value by roughly 7%. Every year. So you've invested $360,000 of your own money, but that money has worked for 30 years and that has earned you $1.2 million in the long run. So you've gained roughly $900,000 on asset appreciation over 30 years just by doing $1,000 every week in an index fund. Now that is the power of compounding. And that is why long-term investing across a broad cross-section of companies is a very powerful way of generating wealth in the long term. So the power of compounding over time is absolutely remarkable. And I'd suggest even having a play around with a compound interest calculator, which I'll put in the description so that you guys can have a bit of a mess around and see what it would be like if you invested $1,000 a month, $2,000, $4,000 a month at roughly 7%, 8%, which is what the stock market returns on average. And you'll see that the returns are quite remarkable, especially over a long period of time. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I really enjoyed making it. Those are the basics of getting starting investing if you have absolutely no idea what you're doing. So make sure you like and subscribe to the channel, and we'll see you later.